The topics covered in this presentation are transistor-transistor logic, comparison between totem pole and open collector output. Features of transistor-transistor logic are, it is a saturated logic, that is, the transistor operates in either saturated state or cutoff state. It uses multi-emitter transistor at input, so there is no need for diode. Number of emitter will be equal to the number of inputs. Output structure can be classified as totem pole, open collector and tri-state structure. High switching speed, small propagation delay, fan out of 10. And here we are going to see the operation of two input NAND gate with totem pole output structure. So NAND gate, so it provides high output when any one of the input is low, and it provides low output when both the inputs are high. So here logic 0 is represented by ground potential at 0 voltage, and logic 1 is represented by plus 5 voltage. And this is a basic structure of two input NAND gate with totem pole output structure. So this structure consists of three stage: input stage, phase splitter stage and output stage. So input stage consists of NPN transistor Q1, and this NPN transistor consists of two emitter. So the number of emitter terminal is equal to the number of input. So this is a two input NAND gate. So two input NAND gate. And second one is phase splitter stage, and this stage consists of Q2 transistor, and this transistor will act as a phase splitter, and the collector terminal of Q2 is connected with the base of the Q3, and emitter terminal is connected with the base of the Q4. So thus the Q2 transistor provides the base voltage for Q3 and Q4. So if base voltage for Q3 is logic 0, then the base voltage for Q4 is logic 1. Or the base voltage for Q3 is logic 1, then the base voltage for Q4 is logic 0. So thus it split the phase voltage for Q3 and Q4. And the third one is output stage, and this stage consists of Q4 transistor, diode D1 and Q3 transistor and R4 resistor. So here Q3 is arranged on the top of the Q4, and this arrangement is called as totem pole arrangement. And diode D1 ensures either Q3 or Q4 is in on state, and the output is collected from the collector terminal of the Q4. And we can draw the diode equivalent for this multi-emitter NPN transistor Q1, and A and B are the inputs, and this base and emitter junction is diode D2 and D3. So D2 and D3 are the base emitter junction, and D4 is the base collector junction, right? So when any one of the input is low or both the inputs are low, so this diode become forward bias, and this diode is in reverse bias. So Q1 is in on state, and on state, so here we are applying the zero potential to the base terminal. So Q2 is in off state, so Q2 will be in off state. So here the base voltage for Q3 will be logic 1, and here the base voltage for Q4 is logic 0, right? So this will be in off condition, this will be in off condition, and this will be in on condition. So we are having the output as logic 1, right? So let us see the working of two input NAND gate with totem pole output structure. So here A and B are the input, and Y is the output, and this Y output collected from the collector terminal of Q4. So A is 0 or B is 0, or both the inputs are 0, that is logic 0, right? Then this base emitter junction is in forward bias, and this base collector is in reverse bias. Then this so this transistor Q1 becomes on state. So on state, so here low voltage is applied to the base terminal of this Q2. So this Q2 is in reverse bias, so it is in off state. So here we are having the logic 1 potential to Q3 base, and logic 0 potential to the Q4 base. So Q4 is in off state and Q3 is in on state. So we are having the current flow from this, right? So we are having the current flow through this Q3 and diode D1. So we are getting the output as logic 1. Right. So when we are applying the high voltage to A and B, so both the inputs are logic 1. Then this base and the emitter junction is in reverse bias, and this base and the collector junction is in forward bias, and this Q1 transistor is in off state. So off state, so there is a current flow through this. So we are having the current flow to the base terminal of this Q2 transistor. So the Q2 becomes in on state, becomes on state. So here we are up here. So logic 0 is applied to the base of the Q3. Logic 0 is applied to the base of the Q3. So Q3 is in off state, and here there is a current flow through this. So there is a current flow. So the current, so the voltage is applied to the base of the Q4. So this Q4 is in on state. So Q4 is in on state. So there is no current flow through this Q3 and D1. So we are not having the output. So the output is logic 0. Right. And next one is two input NAND gate with open collector output. So when we are removing the transistor Q3, diode D1 and R4 resistor from the totem pole configuration, so we are getting the open collector output. So this is a two input NAND gate with open collector configuration. So this configuration, so the collector terminal is not connected with the plus VCC. So this is called as open collector output. For the perfect function of this open collector configuration, so we have to connect the external pull-up resistance to the collector terminal. The comparison between totem pole and open collector output. So totem pole output stage consists of pull up transistor Q3, diode resistor and pull down transistor Q4. External pull up resistor is not required. Output of two gates cannot be tied together. Operating speed is high. Open collector output stage consists of only pull down transistor. External pull up resistor is required for proper operation of gate. Output of two gates can be tied together. Operating speed is low. Hope you understand. Thank you.